Good morning. Ewoks. Wicket in particular. I've always liked the Ewoks. I've got two of them are gear 11. So my Tebow and my Chirper are both gear 11. My Elder and my Scout are currently gear 10. And I thought it would be nice to be able to field an entire Ewok squad. And Wicket was my choice. So what we'll do is we will blow all my lovely credits. I'm not sure how far I'm going to actually be able to gear him just now, but however or wherever it is, that's where he'll go to, obviously. Oh, you know what I didn't do. So here are his stats. So he's gear level 1. Well, gear level 1 1/6. Level 85 now, obviously. 5,458 on his health, 2,625 on his protection, which is all there. Apparently, there's 29 additional speed on him, and 662 physical damage, 603 special damage. That's where he currently resides. I'm gonna sneeze, I'm sorry. Oh, yeah, there we are. I'm sorry. I've woken up sneezy. Really? I'm gonna sneeze again. Oh, wow. I'm really sorry. This is not good. Oh no, please tell me I'm not gonna sneeze again. It's the fur. That's what it is. Up to gear level 5. So what I'll do, I'm gonna pop these on. Excuse me, sorry. That's a residual from the sneezing. I'm just curious to see what the stats are before and after going to. I don't have many of them left. Before hitting the level 7. So 8,000 health. Obviously, the protection is only what's there. Speed has increased. It's now up to 163. 23% potency. 1162 on the physical damage. 735 on the special damage. 10% resistance or 10.5% resistance. Ooh, we can keep on going. So, taking him to gear level 7. Protection jumps up to 5768. I'm going to pop the cheap bits on there. There's some expensive bits, and I want to. Okay. That's as far as he's going at the moment. Gear level 8.5. 9,000 health, 10,000 protection, 163 on the speed. What we do have as well is some shards to deploy. Let's have a look. 10,000 health, 10,000 protection, 1,400 on the physical damage, 894 on the special, 15% resistance. Sorry, I am sniffy. I really am apologetic about that. 11,000 health, 10,000 protection, 1568 on physical damage, 23% armor, 1019 special damage, 16.39 resistance. Twelve thousand 500 health, 10,400 protection, 1,700 physical damage, 24% armor, 1144 for special damage, 1705 for resistance, and finally, so 13,727 health, 10,000 protection, 1834 on special damage, 26% armor, 1268 special damage, 1758 resistance. I've armed a nard and I'm going to deploy in gear 2. Gear level 9. 14,000 health, 15,000 protection, 1946 on physical damage, 1273 on special damage. Yeah, and what we'll do is, as I normally do, is take him up to ability level 7. At some point, I'm gonna have to give him a run. So, deal physical damage to target enemy and gain critical chance up for 2 turns. And the Omega, if an Ewok ally calls Wicket to assist, they also gain critical chance up for 2 turns. Nice. Deal physical damage to all enemies. Ewok allies gain 5% turn meter for each critical hit scored. And the Omega there, deal physical damage to all enemies. Ewok allies gain 10% turn meter for each critical hit scored, and its cooldowns reduced by 1. Deal physical damage to target enemy and call target other ally to assist. If the target ally is an Ewok, Wicket and target ally gain stealth for 2 turns. This is another Omega. If the target ally is an Ewok, Wicket and target ally gain critical damage up for 2 turns. And finally, his unique Wicket gains critical damage percentage for each living Ewok ally and each stealthed ally. At the end of his turn, Wicket has a 50% chance to take another turn. This chance is reduced by 10% if effect is triggered in the previous turn.